In this video, we're computing the moment of inertia of a thick spherical shell with inner radius A, outer radius B, and a mass of capital M. And we're reminded in the problem that we can use the moment of inertia of a thin spherical shell, which is given by 2/3 mr squared, and I'll post a link to the video where that was derived. So the idea of the problem is that we're going to break this thick spherical shell into thin spherical shells between A and B. So there's a representative thin spherical shell. It has an infinitesimal wall thickness and a variable radius as we go from A to B. So we call the radius of our thin spherical shell little r, and then the thickness of the wall is dr, so that's an infinitesimal quantity. And there's the mass of our little shell, that's an incremental contribution to the total mass that we're going to call dm. Now the overall strategy here is that we're going to write down the moment of inertia of this thin spherical shell, and then add up the moments of inertia of all the spherical shells that it takes to build the thick spherical shell from A to B. But before we get started, we need a quick note on density. So density is usually given by the Greek letter rho, and that's the total mass of an object divided by its volume. And we're going to need to use that toward the end of the video. What I want to do right now is mention that we can always solve this for mass and write that the total mass of an object is the density times its volume. But that's true for our infinitesimal thin spherical shell as well. So we can say that dm, the mass of a single thin spherical shell, is given by rho times dv, where dv is the volume of that thin spherical shell. Okay, so this allows us to write the mass of our thin spherical shell as density multiplied by the volume of the thin spherical shell. And here's the trick for figuring that out. It's just the surface area of the thin spherical shell, which is 4 pi r squared, multiplied by the thickness. And if that doesn't seem intuitively true to you, I did go into a lot more detail about justifying that fact in a previous video, and I'll post a link to that at the top. So this means the moment of inertia contribution of our thin spherical shell can be obtained by plugging dm and the radius in to our thin spherical shell formula. So a thin spherical shell has a moment of inertia of 2/3 times the mass, which is dm, times the radius squared. And now we sub in our expression for dm, and I'm going to write that as 4 pi rho r squared dr, and then we still have to tack on this r squared. So we just need to clean up our expression for di, and that gives us 8/3 pi rho r to the fourth dr. So there's the moment of inertia contribution of a single thin spherical shell. Now we just have to add all these up as r goes from A to B. So we start by saying the total moment of inertia is the sum of all the moment of inertia contributions. So the integral is just a summation device here for adding up all these continuously changing infinitesimal contributions. And all we have to do is sub in our definition of di. So that's 8/3 pi rho r to the fourth dr. And then we're summing all these up as we go from the inner radius to the outer radius. So that's when r is a all the way to when r is b. So we have a bunch of constants that are spectators here, 8/3 pi rho. And then when we integrate little r to the fourth, we get 1/5 r to the fifth, and we're evaluating this from A to B. So moving the constants together out in front, we have 8 over 15 times pi rho. And then subbing in the upper limit, we get b to the fifth. Subbing in the lower limit and subtracting it, we end up with minus A to the fifth. All right, so that's one way to write the moment of inertia of the thick spherical shell, but we're not satisfied leaving it this way because we ultimately want to write down a formula for the moment of inertia in terms of big M and the dimensions of the thick spherical shell. So this is where we get back to the definition of density. Density is the mass divided by the volume. So that's the mass of our thick spherical shell divided by the volume of our thick spherical shell. That's given by the volume of the outer sphere of radius b, 4/3 pi b cubed, minus the volume of the inner sphere that we cut out of it, 4/3 pi a cubed. So I'm going to simplify this a little before we sub it in. We'll move the 3 to the numerator, so we have 3m in the numerator, and then divided by a 4 pi, just factoring that out of the denominator, times the quantity b cubed minus a cubed. So now we're going to sub that in for rho in our expression for the moment of inertia. And this gives us 8/15 pi times 3m divided by 4 pi times b cubed minus a cubed times b to the fifth minus a to the fifth. So now there's a lot of cleaning up to do. I can cancel the pi's. I can cancel a factor of 4, leaving me with a 2 in the numerator. Cancel a factor of 3, leaving me with a 5 in the denominator. And I get 2/5 times m. So this is starting out a lot like the formula for a solid sphere. 2/5 times m. But then the rest of it is a lot more complicated. We have b to the 5th minus a to the 5th divided by b cubed minus a cubed. All right, so there's the moment of inertia for a thick spherical shell. But before we quit, I wanted to verify that this formula reduces to the known formulas for a thin spherical shell and for a solid sphere if we take the appropriate limits. So the easiest case to investigate here is the case where a is equal to 0. What that means is the carved out section in the middle of the sphere is shrinking to 0 and we just get a solid sphere. So there's nothing tricky about this limit. We can just replace a with 0 in the expression for the moment of inertia of the thick shell. And we end up with a 2/5 m, and then the a's are just going to cancel out of this. We can just sub in a equals 0, provided it's not a problematic limit. So we end up with a b to the 5th over b cubed, which is b squared. So this gives us our familiar formula for the moment of inertia of a solid sphere, just 2/5 times the mass times the radius squared. So the limit as a goes to b is the more interesting limit here. As a goes to b, all the mass is going to be concentrated in a thin spherical shell of radius b. And this time I'm going to write it formally as a limit because this one is non-trivial. And the reason why is that we end up with a 0 over 0 indeterminate form in this fraction. When a approaches b, b to the 5th minus a to the 5th is 0 and b cubed minus a cubed is 0. So we're going to have to apply L'Hôpital's rule to this thing. Now it's important to keep in mind that when we apply L'Hôpital's rule, a is the variable quantity here and b is treated as a constant. So a is the thing that's changing and it's getting close to b. So we can go ahead and take the a derivative of the numerator and the denominator. And in the numerator, this gives me negative 5a to the 4th. In the denominator, negative 3a squared. And our minus signs are going to cancel out and two factors of a are going to cancel out. And this 5 is going to cancel out and I end up with a 2/3 m and a is approaching b, so I end up with b squared. So now with both of these limits working out, we have a high degree of confidence that our formula for the thick spherical shell is correct. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.